What's up, everyone? Welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are taking a look at the all-new Kia Stinger GT. So, the first effort by Kia for, well, a sports saloon, really. It's a five-door coupe, or a liftback, I don't know how to call it. But the entire rear end goes up, so technically it's a hatchback. But it's a coupe roofline, of course. And it's a GT. So the name is GT, but it really is a Gran Turismo, as you will find out later. Because other than the looks, I mean, I don't know if I think it's pretty, but at least it's different than the usual stuff that Kia does. And of course, it's also different than the other competitors in this class. So Audi S4 or S5, BMW 440i, Alfa Giulia, Jaguar XE maybe, Mercedes C-Class, cars like those. And well, let's start with the design. So we have it in red, and I think it looks quite good, especially with all those sort of gray details and glossy black, or whatever this is. Pretty cool. I think the front looks good, quite aggressive. I don't like these, or I like the look of them, but I don't like that this is fake, so why not just make this functional? These are functional, so they are open, as well as those. And well, these wheels are quite nice as well, 19 inch as standard with very nice winter tires. We are going to take it to the Autobahn later on in this video. So we have Vredestein Giugiaro tires, Wintrek Extreme 2 with a Y code. So they are limited at 300 kilometers an hour. So that's good, because this car actually has a top speed of 270. So that's great. At the rear, quad exhaust pipe with the badges Stinger and GT AWD. In the Netherlands, we can only get the GT as an all-wheel drive version, so no rear-wheel drive, because this is actually the first rear-wheel drive Kia has ever made. So that is pretty cool as well. So let's take a look inside. We have some very nice sports seats. Leather quality is pretty nice, actually. And they are really supportive and still very comfy. And they are adjustable in many, many ways. So in here, I mean, this car is just loaded with stuff, with goodies, as standard. So that's something I really like about Kia, is that they just said, okay, we're going to make a sporty saloon, and we are going to try to do something new, but we are still going to do, yeah, the Kia way. So it actually has a lot of standard equipment, stuff you'd be paying a lot of money for with the competitors. So for instance, the GT has as standard heated and ventilated front seats. It also has heated rear seats. We have this panoramic roof. Don't know if that's standard or not, but it has a rear view camera, stuff like that. It's just loaded with goodies. And we have a nice leather steering wheel. This is stolen from Audi, I think. This as well. They have paid attention to what the others are doing, clearly, and they have taken their inspiration from it. So I actually quite like this interior. I think it looks good. I think the materials look quite good, except for this. I think this looks really old-fashioned. This all feels really nice. It's quite soft. So I don't really understand this. I've said it in the Hyundai i30N video as well. This is just, it's not good enough. And in an i30, you can get away with it, probably. But in a car that costs this much and that has to compete with BMW 4 Series, Audi S4, stuff like that. You just can't compete with this screen, which is just not really sharp. Frame rate is not great. It's a bit laggy. The design is a bit old-fashioned as well. Yeah, I don't really like it. The screen in there is better. So you have, you know, your digital speedometer, your driving modes, fuel economy, stuff like that. And a compass, some settings. It also has adjustable side support on the seats. There it is, which I really like, because there are sporty cars from premium brands that we drive that don't have that. I'm looking at you, Mercedes. And I really hate that, because I want to be snug in my sports car. So what else can I show you? Leg room in the rear is quite okay. Headroom is not that spacious, of course, because you have that coupe roofline. We have some stuff here, cup holders. This is the key. Looks like an explosive detonator with sound effects by Max from Autotop.nl. And I wanted to show you this. Maybe you've seen it before. We use these Montar phone mounts to put on the window and show our logo or a GPS speedo in the Autobahn POVs. And we got a lot of questions from people asking what it was and which one it was. This is the best one we've had so far. If you want one, you can buy it with the discount code Autotop.nl. You get 15% off. Just click on the link in the description and buy one if you want one. So let's go for a drive. Oh, I want to show you something that's very annoying. Okay, we had this in the Hyundai as well. So of course Kia is owned by Hyundai, so that's not a surprise, but listen to this. Come on, I don't want to listen to the South Korean state music every time I start or stop my car. I think it is totally unnecessary. I'm sure you can turn it off, but come on, why is it even in there? It's ridiculous. Okay, let's go for a drive. Oh, no. I want to show you the engine, or I want to see the engine, because I haven't seen it either. Okay, so there it is, 3.3 liter V6 bi-turbo. Turbo, yeah! I think they stole that from some 80s TV show, that logo. Okay, not that interesting, but I wanted to show it anyway. Let's go. Okay, so Kia Stinger GT. First effort to build a sports car by Kia. And well, like we saw with the Hyundai i30N, they are really serious about this. Both for Hyundai and Kia, Albert Biermann, the former M guy, is the head of the sports divisions. And well, this car is based on the platform of the Hyundai Genesis G80. So they just took that and went all out with sporty stuff, sporty settings. We have adaptive everything, or at least adaptive driving modes. So we can go for smart, which is quite clever. It's supposed to learn the way you are driving and adjust the car's settings to that. Pretty cool. Eco, which just muffles everything in an attempt to cut fuel economy. Comfort mode, well, it speaks for itself. Then we have Sport and Sport Plus. And I think the only difference between Sport and Sport Plus is that in Sport Plus the traction control is disengaged. And we can go even further. To engage launch control, for instance, you have to put it in Sport and then keep this traction control button
pressed for 3 seconds, and then you can use launch control. So this car is actually quite powerful. It feels really beefy. It does pack some shove. It's very punchy, this engine. Try to keep it clean. Don't think I succeeded there. The engine feels quite punchy. It feels really torquey. I don't really like the way it sounds. I think it's a bit distant and there's not a lot of drama there, not a lot of emotion. Let me demonstrate right here. I mean, it sounds okay. It's not that loud, and well, yeah, it's just, it's not very exciting, but it is seriously quick, this car. 4.9 seconds to 100 kilometers an hour, because we have the all-wheel drive version, as I said. 5.1 seconds if you have the rear-wheel drive version. I mean, that's quick. This car is heavy. It's 1800 kilos, something like that. So it's quite a lot heavier than its competition, actually. But still, it feels quite quick. It feels nimble enough. It doesn't feel like a car of this size, because this is just a bit smaller than a 5 series. So it's not too bad, actually. It feels quite small. Well, it feels smaller than it actually is. Balance feels okay as well. I mean, you do feel the weight there. But you do feel that the suspension and the chassis are designed in a way to hide the weight. And it feels, yeah, quite supple and playful, actually. And if you push it hard enough in a corner, you can actually get the rear to step out. I'm not sure you're going to do massive drifts and slides, maybe when it's wet. But because it's all-wheel drive, you know, it regains grip quite quickly. Okay, so there's no one around. Let's do a launch control. So I'm in sport now. Press this for 3 seconds. There we go. Foot on the brake, full throttle. Launch control ready. And that's 100. So not bad. It's not really that violent, the launch control. It's more of a sort of a brake launch. But still, 4.9 seconds. I mean, that's really respectable. So this car, as I said, has to compete with a BMW 440i or an Audi S4. And, well, I have to say that it's more powerful than both, of course. And it really feels more aggressive than both. It feels like it has a lot more turbo torque, so to speak. So that it comes in this wave of torque, and it actually feels really powerful. And, you know, I think that's a good start if you want to compete with them. Just, okay, start with being faster, because you're not going to win it on interior refinement or stuff like that, or chassis controls. So you have to commend Kia for starting with the right stuff and trying to convince people to go for this Kia instead of one of those cars. I have to say, they have surprised me quite a bit with this car. I thought that it was not going to be this good. I didn't think it was going to be this fast either. We are going to take it to the Autobahn as well, as I said. But I think this car will impress at the Autobahn. Okay, so that's it for this part. Let's take it to the Autobahn, because I'm really, really curious to see how it performs over there. Okay, at the Autobahn now, and we are here to test the capabilities of that 3.3 liter V6 biturbo engine. 370 horsepower, 510 newton meters, as I said. So let's check it out. Of course, It's called the GT, the Stinger GT, and Kia have said that this really is a Gran Turismo. So, like I experienced before, this chassis is really supple and smooth, so it should be perfect for the Autobahn. Some V6 sound through the speakers, and we're off. And I have to say, it is actually quite quick. So that's 200 already. We're still in comfort actually, so I'll switch to sport. Bit of wind noise now, 250. It starts wobbling a bit, or being a bit wayward, but it could also be the winter tires. That's 266, 7, 8. Come on, Kia! 9, 270. So that's the top speed, 271. That is actually quite impressive. And I really, really like that it's limited at 270, or that the top speed is 270 and not 250 like all those German competitors and other competitors too now. Okay, so let's try the flappy pedals again. So this is fourth gear, third gear. And it does auto upshift, so I can't hit the rev limiter. I don't really like that. Okay, so the gear shift itself is not bad, but the response to the pedal is a bit delayed, both on downshift and upshift. Little imbalance in the braking there. Don't know why that is. Well, the gearbox is not that bad. It's not as fast as the BMW ZF, for instance, or of course a dual clutch gearbox, but it's not bad. But here's a weird thing. It doesn't go to the red line. It shifts at 6.5 or 6,000 RPM in both third and fourth gear. That's weird. Okay. So the main thing about this car, of course, is that it's a brand builder for Kia. We have never seen anything like this from Kia. It's their first attempt at making a sporty car, or at least in this segment. And we've seen that they are very serious. Like Hyundai, Albert Biermann is responsible for this car and for the setup of this car, who previously was a chief at BMW M. So they knew what they were doing, and you know, that's very clear. And I have to say, for first attempt, it's really a credible attempt, because a couple of years ago, if you would have told me that I would be driving a Kia on the Autobahn going 270 kilometers an hour, I would have laughed in your face. But this car really is, it drives well enough to be taken seriously. It looks good enough to stand out. And it has all those features, both like on safety and entertainment, that, you know, it does offer an interesting package. Unfortunately, in the Netherlands, we have that CO2 dependent taxes. So in the Netherlands, it's ridiculously expensive. I think 99,000 euros for this Kia Stinger GT, which is a lot. But that's because this car emits as much CO2 as a Porsche Panamera Turbo with that V8, and which weighs 2,000 kilos or just over 2,000 kilos. So that's ridiculous. That's not, yeah, that's not good for its price here in the Netherlands. But the chassis is really good, actually. It's comfortable. The steering is a bit vague and you don't really feel that connected to the road, but the suspension is really good. I would have liked a bit more sound in here though, but it's a GT, so okay. And I read that they have a US spec exhaust, which wasn't approved for EU, for the EU market, so that's a shame. So competitors: BMW 440i, Audi S5 Sportback, maybe an Alfa Giulia, maybe a Jaguar XE, cars like those. And well, you have to build a really, really, really good car to be able to get customers from those cars into this. And I can't say that it's on the same level already, but it's a really good first effort and it bodes well for the future if this is their first effort. So I'm curious to see what else they come up with. And I'm going to end it there. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. You can subscribe by clicking on the little icon in the bottom right corner. And you can follow us on social media. Just search for AutoTopNL. Thanks, guys. Bye.